generally I'm classified as a parasitologist, so I study organisms that live on or within hosts. And my main interest in our laboratory is transmission of parasites. So how do they get from one host to another? A lot of parasitic organisms have really complex life cycles where they have one, two, three, or four hosts. And, you know, one of the most, you know, intriguing questions in biology and zoology is, what is it and how do you know? And so as we study our parasites and the ecology of those parasites, the transmission, we also start asking questions, what is it, how do you know, and do a little bit of taxonomy and systematics, naming parasites and trying to understand, you know, how they're related. So that's kind of in a nutshell what we do, you know, transmission, ecology, what parasites are, how are they related in their evolutionary importance. Numerous animals and humans that are affected by parasitism. There's also parasites that affect, you know, insects and other animals that may not be as important to humans, but overall, you know, they can affect the ecosystem, the health of all those organisms, you know, and just the general knowledge of knowing what is in Oklahoma. First of all, the broad knowledge that parasitism is really the most common way of life. Almost every group of animals and plants out there has parasitic species. And it's so common that there are similar trends in those parasitic lifestyles, you know. And I think that the other important thing that I try to have my students realize is whatever project you're working on, you really have to complete that project. So you have to pick questions and methods to do them to be able to do it in a set amount of time and move on to something else, you know. I don't like students to kind of drag on and continue working on the same thing. And I think students in my lab usually get that idea that, you know, you have to put in time to do this and complete those projects and move on to newer questions and things of that nature. The camaraderie, you know, the students are good. Every semester I teach animal biology, and I have anywhere from 70 to 290 students, and a lot of the students after my course really approach me to, because they're excited about some of the parasites I talk about, to go in and actually do research. So I think that's a great resource for someone who wants to teach students and have them do research. We've set up a website called www.nematomorpha.net, which is the name of the phylum, and one thing we're trying to do is have people from all over Oklahoma and all over the U.S. actually, when they find these, you know, weird worms in their toilets and their water bowls, to actually send them to us so we can identify them for them and tell them what they are, you know, and potentially be able to use them in our research to see how they relate to other species.